Hey, welcome again to Pastor's Corner. I feel like just saying I'm back again from West Hudson Christian Center in Kearney. It's a great privilege and a great honor to come to you just wherever you are, just to share a short word of reflection with you in this season as we await upon the Lord. I know how it's been very tough and very difficult in these few months, starting last year to now, dealing with COVID and being in the period of pandemic, and most of us being distant from relating and really coming together to fellowship and stuff like that. I've done a lot of reflection on the need for all these things and that, but I feel that this period of COVID-19, where we are being somehow needing to be distant from each other, kind of like in person and stuff like that, the in-person relation, it's a time where we really need to begin to reflect on our relationship with God. I know many people have said that it's difficult for them because they miss that and fellowshipping with people and stuff like that, which I think it's right, because God has created us to relate with people and one another and to love people and be with one another. That bond is good. But I also feel that in this COVID season, we can work on that distance that for many years and decades we have had away from God. And so while we have just finished celebrating Easter, remembering the salvational work of our Lord Jesus Christ on the surface of this earth, and now we are in the period of just preparing ourselves for Pentecost Sunday around the world coming. And now most people are beginning to look forward to Pentecost. And I want to begin to bring our attention for the need of having an intimacy with God. And so in this season, I've been talking a lot about the need to have the Spirit of God in our life. And last week, I did touch on God promising to pour out His Spirit on all flesh. Please do go back and listen to that reflection if you can. On the other hand, today I'm going to continue speaking on the need of the Holy Spirit. I spoke about how God has promised to give us His Spirit, and we should desire that. And I did take good time talking about desire. Now, we are coming to look at today's reflection. And I want to take it from James chapter 4, verse 2. It says, "You lust and do not have. You murder and covet and cannot obtain. You fight and war, yet you do not have because you do not ask." I will spend some more time next week talking about the previous ones. James is speaking to Christians. And look at the words that he put together. He say, "You lust." Wow. Lust. "And do not have." "You murder." Wow. Christians murder. "And covet and cannot obtain." Covetousness and all these things. I will touch on it late next week, God willing. But today I'm looking at the last part, the B part of this verse, which says that, "Yet you do not have because you do not ask." And as I told you already, I've talked about how last week I looked at desiring the outpouring of the Spirit, because God has promised that He will pour out the Spirit on all flesh. Today, I'm saying that it is important to desire, but you cannot keep going desiring without asking, because if you do not ask, you will not receive. You will not receive. And so the point is this: we must ask. We must ask. Don't desire without asking for the infilling. You might say, "Pastor Vance, I'm filled already. I received the Holy Ghost years ago." Oh, yes, it is true. We must grow and be constantly be filled. Why? Because we are human beings that drain, the presence of the Spirit drains out of us, because we come across a lot of circumstances and situations that demands the Holy Spirit to be in operation in our lives. And so if you and I are not constantly being filled, we come to a point where we become staled or drained by life situations and challenges that come our way. Every day we step out of our homes, we have challenges that we need the Holy Spirit to help us. Even in our own homes, under our own roof, there are challenges that come across us that we need the Holy Spirit to help us. Jesus said that the Spirit, when He comes upon us, will give us power to be His witnesses. And so every believer must desire to have more and more and more of the outpouring of the Spirit. Our cups must overflow with the Holy Spirit. The Word of God says that Jesus said that out of you shall flow rivers of living waters. And so we must overflow with living waters. We must overflow with the Holy Spirit. And so it is important that you and I do not say, "Oh, I was baptized a while ago." If you are not baptized, it is time to ask, desire, and begin to ask. If you are baptized already, you must still desire to have more of outpouring and begin to ask. So what does it mean to ask? That is the word these days we say, pray, pray. We must pray. You and I must pray and ask purposely. One of my personal prayers that I pray is, "Lord, I receive the Holy Spirit. I pray that you shall pour out your Holy Spirit upon me. I pray this prayer for myself. I pray this prayer for my children. I pray it for my wife. I pray it for my church members. I pray in the name of Jesus for the outpouring, constant outpouring of the Holy Spirit." But guess what? Jesus said in John chapter 14, verse 12 to 15, He says, "Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these he will do, because I go to my Father, and whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, and the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it." Hallelujah. You see, when I read the scriptures and I see stuff like this, I get so excited. Jesus says that anything we, his children, ask in his name, he will do it. There is no may or if or whatever. He says that will do it. Jesus has given us an assurance. We must ask. We must take pleasure in this, in asking. We must not stop. We must bombard heaven in this season. You have to desire. And in addition to desiring, you have to begin to ask, "Lord, fill me. Lord, increase me. Lord, empower me. I need you, Holy Spirit, in my life." Every child of God must, in this season, begin to seek more deeply the presence of the Holy Spirit. And you must begin to relate with the Holy Spirit, seek His encounter, seek His presence, seek His fellowship with you. And while you are separated from people, this is the time you want to really begin to be connected even more with heaven. I tell you, if heaven is closer to you, God says that He's closer to us even than the clothes that we wear. He knows the number of hair. You see, I have bald head. He knows how many has not grown, or even how many I just shaved this morning. God is awesome. He wants to come very close into our life through the Holy Spirit. And Jesus says that if we ask anything in His name, He will give us. My dear brother and my dear sister, don't stop. You see, Jesus in the verse 12 says, "Most assuredly," which means that this is serious. He says, "Most assuredly," it is with seriousness. And then when you continue to read, he says that the things that he did, we will do greater. It all points that we need the presence of the Holy Spirit in our life so that we can do the works and the greater works that Jesus has begun on this, the surface of this earth already. My dear brother and my dear sister, you and I cannot only desire. If you are not desiring, begin to desire for the infilling. Begin to desire for the outpouring of the Spirit in your life. And not just that. If you are desiring, it is time to begin to pray. Add prayer to it. Add asking to it. Lord, I need to be filled. And I want to read again the last verse of John chapter 14, verse 14 to you. It says, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Jesus says he will do it. Yeah. Take delight in this. Take joy in this. Trust him, believe him, and begin to ask. Because the Father has promised. You are asking in God's name. You are asking according to the Father's will that you be filled. And I have no doubt. I have no doubt that if you do this with all seriousness and diligently, you will be increased. You will be impacted. You will see the Holy Spirit seriously at work in your life. And in this season, you will be brooding. You will be growing. The Holy Spirit will begin to empower you and teach you and get you ready for the move and the work that the Father is preparing the church to do very soon. God bless you. May his peace be with you. And may his strength be your portion. Amen. Amen.